Hello students, today let us learn the lesson winds, storms and cyclones. You have learnt in your previous classes the properties of air. They are: air has weight, air occupies space, moving air is called wind. What is wind? Moving air is called wind. The instrument used to measure the speed of wind is anemometer. Name the instrument used to measure the speed of wind. It is anemometer. Let us learn some more properties of air. Air exerts pressure. Students, look at the screen. It is easy to fly a kite in the direction of wind. It is easy to row a boat in the direction of wind. If you want to row the boat against the direction of wind, you have to put some effort. It is difficult to row. Third picture. You know that we have to fill air into the bicycle tube to keep it tight. A bicycle tube overfilled with air may burst. What is the air doing inside the tube? The air exerts pressure. The air exerts pressure. All these experiences show that air exerts pressure. It is due to this pressure, the leaves of trees, banners, or flags flutter when the wind is blowing. Activity 8.2. Activity 8.2. Take a bottle, fill it with hot water, close its cap tightly. Keep the bottle or place the bottle under running water. Students, you conduct this activity and record your observation. When the bottle is placed under running water, the bottle gets distorted. Why? Because as water is poured over the bottle or can, some steam inside the bottle condenses into water, reducing the amount of air inside. The pressure of air inside the can decreases. The pressure exerted by the air from outside the bottle increases. As a result, the can or bottle gets compressed. Students, once again you listen. Inside the bottle there is hot air. When cold water is poured over the bottle, air or steam in the bottle condenses into water and it reduces the amount of air. So the pressure of air inside the bottle decreases. The pressure exerted by the air from outside the bottle increases. As a result, the bottle gets compressed. Increased wind speed is accompanied by reduced air pressure. Students, look at the screen. Blowing between the balloons. When you blew between the balloons, they moved towards each other. Why? Because when you blew between the balloons, the air pressure between the balloons decreases. When you blew between the balloons, the air pressure between the balloons decreases. The air pressure outside the balloons push them towards each other. So they come towards each other. When you blew the balloons, the air pressure between the balloons decreases. The pressure outside the balloons pushes them towards each other. So the balloons come close to each other. Blowing over a strip of paper. In this activity, the air pressure over the strip decreases. The air pressure over the strip decreases, so the strip moves upwards. Air pressure over the strip decreases. As a result, the strip moves upwards. Third activity, blowing into the bottle. When we blow into the mouth of the bottle, the air near the mouth has higher speed. This decreases the pressure there. This decreases the pressure near the mouth. The air pressure inside the bottle is more. The air inside the bottle pushes the ball out. Students, the air near the mouth is, or the air pressure near the mouth is less. The air pressure inside the bottle is more. So, it pushes the ball out. The air pressure near the mouth of the bottle is less. So, it pushes the ball out. Students, these are your home assignments. Conduct these activities. You will understand better. What did you understand from this activity? From this activity, we can understand that increased wind speed is accompanied by reduced air pressure. When the speed of the wind increases, it reduces the air pressure. Increased wind speed is accompanied by reduced air pressure. When the speed of the wind increases, the air pressure decreases. Next property, air expands on heating. Students, activity 8.5. Take a tube and fix a balloon to it. Keep this tube in boiling water. Students, instead of a boiling tube, you can use a bottle and fix a balloon to its mouth. Keep the boiling tube or bottle in hot water and observe the balloon. Now, remove the boiling tube from hot water and keep it in cold water or ice cold water. Observe the balloon. When the balloon is kept in hot water, it swells, inflated. When it is removed from the hot water and kept in cold water, the balloon is deflated. Why? Because when the boiling tube is kept in hot water, the air expands and the balloon swells. When it is kept in ice cold water, the air contracts and the balloon gains its initial shape. When it is kept in ice cold water, the air contracts and the balloon gains its initial shape. Students, conduct this activity and record your observation. Activity 8.6. Take two paper bags or empty paper cups of the same size and prepare a balance as shown in the figure. Place a burning candle below one of the bags and record your observation. As the warm air rises up, it pushes the bag above the candle. The balance is disturbed. From this activity, we can understand that warm air is lighter than the cold air. Warm air is lighter than the cold air. Warm air rises up and it disturbs the balance. Warm air rises up and disturbs the balance. Warm air is lighter than the cold air. Students, conduct this activity. Why smoke always rises up? Why smoke always rises up? Do you know? On heating, the air expands and occupies more space. On heating, the air expands and occupies more space. The warm air is lighter than the cold air. The warm air is lighter than the cold air. That is why the smoke goes up. Warm air is lighter than the cold air. On heating, air expands. Warm air is lighter than the cold air, so the smoke goes up. Children, you can see the pollution. Pollution every time goes up because warm air is lighter than the cold air. Wind currents are generated due to uneven heating on the earth. You might have learnt in geography that regions close to the equator get maximum heat from the sun. The air in these regions gets warm. The warm air rises and the cooler air from the poles come towards the equator. Again, these air molecules will be heated. They move towards the poles. Again, cold air molecules move towards the equator. This results in convection current. This results in convection current, or it is called wind current. Uneven heating of land and water. In summer, near the equator, the land warms up faster. The air over the land gets heated and rises. The air over the land gets heated and rises. This causes the winds to flow from the oceans towards the land. These are called monsoon winds. The winds from the oceans carry water and bring grain. The winds from the oceans carry water and bring rain. In nature itself, there are certain situations that can sometimes create disasters and pose threat to humans, animals, and plant life. The two important situations are thunderstorms and cyclones. What is a thunderstorm? Thunderstorms are seen in hot, humid, tropical areas. The rising temperature produces strong upward rising winds. These winds carry water droplets upwards, where they freeze and fall down again. The swift movement of the water droplets, or convection current, along with the rising air, create lightning and sound. This is called a thunderstorm. This is called a thunderstorm with lightning and sound. Rising air create lightning and sound. This is called a thunderstorm. What are the precautions to be taken during a thunderstorm? Do not take shelter under an isolated tree. Do not take shelter under an umbrella with a metallic end, because metals are good conductors of electricity. Do not sit near a window, because window bars are made of iron. If you are in water, get out and go inside a building. Cyclones. When water vapor in the clouds cools down, it releases heat. This heat warms the air around the clouds. The warm air rises up and creates low pressure area. This low pressure area is quickly filled in by cooler air from the surrounding. This creates a system in which the center is having very low pressure and is surrounded by wind moving around it. The wind from the surroundings moves in a circular fashion towards the center and gives rise to cyclone. Factors that contribute to the development of a cyclone. The intensity of a cyclone depends on wind speed, wind direction, temperature, humidity. Wind speed, wind direction, temperature and humidity. Tornado. A tornado is a dark funnel shaped cloud that reaches from the sky to the ground. Protecting from a tornado. One has to bow down on knees, protecting head and neck using arms. What are the destructions caused by cyclones? Cyclones can be very destructive. The water waves produced by the wind are so powerful. As a result, the sea water enters the low-lying coastal areas, causing severe loss of life and property. It also reduces the fertility of the soil. High-speed winds can damage houses. They can damage telephones and other communication systems. Damage trees. Safety measures. Measures taken by the government. Rapid communication of warnings to the government agencies, the ports, fishermen, ships and to the general public. Construction of cyclone shelters in the cyclone prone areas and administrative arrangements for moving people fast to safer places. Action on the part of the public. Don't ignore the warnings issued by the Meteorological Department. make arrangement to shift the essential goods, animals and vehicles to safer places. Avoid driving on roads through standing water. Keep ready the phone numbers of all emergency services like police, fire brigade and medical centers. What are the precautions to be taken if you are staying in a cyclone hit area? Don't drink contaminated water. Store drinking water. Do not touch wet switches and fallen power lines. Do not go out for the sake of fun. Don't make undue demands. Cooperate and help your neighbors. How do we come to know that a cyclone is approaching? If you are living closer to the ocean areas, you can see higher water waves. It is one of the indications of cyclone is approaching. The world today is very different. Thanks to satellites and radars, a cyclone alert or cyclone watch is issued 48 hours in advance of any expected storm, and a cyclone warning is issued 24 hours in advance. The message is broadcast every hour or half an hour when a cyclone is nearer the coast. Dear students, here we completed the lesson Winds, Storms and Cyclones. Conduct the activities given in the textbook. You will understand better. If any doubts, please contact me. Thank you.